It's not like the Allies just got woke in 1942 and decided to open the doors to women. They had run out of men. The spies who sabotaged the Nazis, armed the resistance, and helped win World War II.
The invasion of Europe has begun.
When we think about D-Day, we think about the largest seaboard invasion in the world in the history of mankind, and we always think about the men on the beaches, teenage boys hitting the beaches and taking back Europe from Hitler. It turns out there were women behind the lines commanding troops too. So for 5 years, Hitler controlled all of Europe. There was no democracy anywhere on the continent of Europe. D-Day was the day that the Allies came back. They invaded France, and they took down Hitler. Imagine being 3 years into a war with nothing to celebrate. Not a single battle has gone your way. Imagine getting a call from the government saying, you have a skill, you alone have a skill that could change this. Would you go for the work for your government? Would you do it if you had three little kids at home and your husband was already fighting? Odette Sampson did. She got trained as a secret agent in sharpshooting, encryption, safe cracking, explosives and demolitions. She learned how to parachute and she returned to France to become a secret agent and army resistance. She escapes Ravensbrück with evidence that would be used in war crimes trials to put away the commandant of the largest women's prison in history. Odette became the face of this secret agency that helped arm and train the resistance. She became its most celebrated agent. André Borel was 22 years old when she parachuted into France as the first female combat paratrooper in the history of the world. She had left school at 14, had pretty much no social prospects, but the minute Hitler moved into France, she went south and started working on an underground railroad where she helped 65 Allied evaders escape, downed pilots, and she got 65 men out until she was betrayed, and she had to go out the same method by the Underground Railroad, same way she'd helped men escape. She goes to London, she gets recruited for a secret agency, she becomes a train killer, a weapon, and asked to be parachuted back in. She is the one who helps seed those networks so that when the Allies come, there are resistance forces behind the line, ready to keep Hitler's reinforcements from the beaches. Lise de Bessac was in her late 30s. She went on two secret missions to France. On her second mission, she worked in Normandy as second in command of the French resistance behind the lines on the very day the Allies returned, June 5th, 1944. The resistance made 950 cuts on bridges and roads and railways so that when the troops arrived in the morning on the beaches, Hitler's reinforcements couldn't get to the beaches. She also helped take down telephone wires and blow up underground communication cables, which meant that the Nazis had to broadcast their troop movements on the radio. It's not like the Allies just got woke in 1942 and decided to open the doors to women. They had run out of men. All of these women had one skill, one important skill, that the Allies needed and no one else had. They were fluent in French. They could fool the French, they could fool the Germans. It's important to know that there were women in history who were in leadership roles. Their work gets dismissed as secretarial, or they were messengers, but in fact, they were doing the exact same work as men. They were changing the world.